Selamat siang, Bapak Ibu. Please, in the chat box, you can just mention your name. You can also mention your school name and also your region. You can please do that. We'll start the session in a couple of minutes. Terima kasih. Thank you. And Bapak Ibu, if in case the Zoom quota is full, please be informed that it is also being broadcasted on the YouTube, the link which is there in the WhatsApp group. So just for information, Bapak Ibu. Terima kasih. Thank you.
Maybe you can float one Google sheet to all of them so that they can send their YouTube link in that sheet so that sometimes we can also have a look on their progress and
which one, sir? Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Sorry.
The link, I mean, the channel was what they have created and they are recording their videos and uploading there. So their channel, their video YouTube channel link, you can collect in the Google sheet so that it can be handy for others.
Sir, yeah. Sir, they have kept me busy the whole day yesterday.
Okay.
So, un sabka link hai sir, hamare paas. I'll definitely share all the details. Sir. Yes. Sir, actually, mereko ek video upload karna. I'm not able to see the video. One minute, maybe it's from here.
I have made you co-host, so you have all the rights.
Ah, sir, sure. Thank you, sir. Thanks. Sir, can you see my screen, Kuch?
Yes.
Selamat siang, Bapak Ibu. A very good afternoon to all of you all. We are almost touching 340 participants. So I think we will start, sir, because then we'll get late for the whole session, right?
Sure.
Okay. Selamat siang. A very good afternoon to you. Namaste. Greetings from India, from Marwadi University, from Tie-Ups International, and also from Apticom Jawa Timur. So, Bapak Ibu, thank you so much. Thanks a lot for your active participation. I'm sure you're meeting Pa Dhananjay for the second time today, but you're meeting me probably for the third time because you've been in touch with me almost the whole day yesterday with your videos. Thank you so much, Bapa Ibu. Thanks a lot for making the videos. Some of them, sir, just to inform you, quite a good number of teachers, they have made the videos. They were a bit hesitant. They were a bit, they were not happy with the videos initially. But then I can tell you, overall, I've got feedback where teachers are very happy. They had a YouTube channel, but they never used their YouTube channel. But now they are using their YouTube channel. And they really appreciate it. And they're very happy about it. And I believe me, sir, I repeated your words. Learning is an experience. So that is an experience for them. So I think they have done it. And also there was another one thing which you said was learning happens what learner does and not what the teacher does.
That's right.
So this is something they have also put that into their videos. And we do have the YouTube links, which I'll later share that along with you.
Right.
So thank you so much, all the teachers. Terima kasih banyak, Bapak Ibu. Thank you so much for your participation. We really appreciate that. Now let's move forward today, Bapak Ibu, for the second session. today's session, before we get into the main session, we just have Kitapikir Bapaibu. Why not we share some information about Apticom, Jawa Timur Bapaibu, dan juga ada sedikit informasi tentang India dan Pendidikan India. So please allow me, Bapaibu, to share that information to you. So this is a video. It's a very small video about Apticom.
No, your video is not visible, only the document. Raviji, the video is not visible. Only your downloads files are visible on the screen.
You can see it, right, sir?
No, video is not visible. Only the screen, that is your downloads list of the files.
Oh. Is it? Because I did share the screen, sir. Just a minute. Sir, can you see the screen now, sir?
No, the same thing I'm seeing here.
Oh. Okay, then probably we'll run this video tomorrow. So then we'll just try to find out the thing.
Yeah.
Maaf, Bapak Ibu, ini ada sesuatu, there's some technical problem. We'll run this video later. Bapak Ibu, please allow me to give you some information about India dan Pendidikan India. So yes, screen, can you see the screen, sir?
Yes, yes, your slide deck is visible.
Okay, Bapak Ibu, as of now, Bapak Ibu, what you know about India, ya Bapak Ibu? Adalah yang ini. Pasti Bapak Ibu yang kenal India, you all know of India about Shah Rukh Khan, Shahir Sheikh, dance, Ramayana, Mahabharata. Of course, Bapak Ibu udah lihat nonton kuch-kuch hota hai, mungkin 20 times, but you all love watching it again. And of course, everyone likes to go to Taj Mahal and you all do know Kajol also. Tapi Bapak Ibu hari ini, we would like to give you some more information about the real India, because not many people, banyak Bapak Ibu yang belum kenal sama the real India. So that's why, just give me 5 to 10 minutes to finish this information quickly. So this is the information, Bapak Ibu. This is India. This is, if you look at this, this is the map of India. Ini adalah peta India. Kalau utara dari selatan, timur sampai barat, it's a big country, Bapak Ibu. From utara ke selatan, it's almost 3,300 kilometers. From timur ke barat, it's almost 2,400 kilometers. Yang ibu kota, Bapak Ibu, adalah New Delhi. That's the capital. And penduduk adalah 1.3 miliar orang, hampir 5 kali lipat kalau kita bandingin sama Indonesia. Languages, Bapak Ibu, we speak Hindi, we speak English, all the languages, but one thing, Bapak Ibu, you need to remember, English, everyone in India can understand, everyone can speak. Grammar is not that good, but I can tell you communication takes place through English. Every province in India, they could understand English. Maybe the grammar is not that focused because the focus is more on the communication. Now the religions, Bapak Ibu, we have Hinduism, we have Islam, we have Sikhism, we have Buddhism. India is a secular country, Bapak Ibu. The currency is rupee. India is the world's third largest education network in the world. And Bapak Ibu, if you look at this, this is Andaman and Nicobar Island, which is a part of India. And if you look at this, Maaf, this is a bit small, but this is Indonesia, Bapak Ibu. If you see these small islands, this is Indonesia. So India and Indonesia are actually maritime neighbors. We are just 300 kilometers away, Bapak Ibu. So if we feel India agar jau, it's actually not. India and Indonesia are very close. But only thing is we don't know about it, Bapak Ibu. And that's what we would like to inform you today. The education system of India, same, Bapak Ibu, sama, hampir sama seperti Indonesia. We have the SJ, we have the SMP, we have the SMA, we have the S1, we have the S2, and also we have the S3. Just one thing, Bapak Ibu, the S1, the India, the bachelor program in India is for 3 years, non-technical program, and the technical program is for 4 years, Bapak Ibu. But all the degrees from India are recognized around the world, and it is also recognized in Indonesia, Bapak Ibu. Some more information about India, Bapak Ibu, the first university of the world. Kalau saya tanya, Bapak Ibu, Pasti Bapak Ibu pikir the first university of the world comes from maybe from the UK, from the US. But Bapak Ibu, you all don't know that the first university of the world actually comes from India. Now, India is the world's third largest network, as I mentioned to you. Also, Bapak Ibu, India has the world's fourth largest number of PhDs. So that means the education in India is taught by PhDs. So that means you can understand the quality of education and also the quality of the lecturers who are teaching in the Indian education system. And the courses, the degrees, yang ijazah yang kalau kita dapat dari India, it is recognized all over the world. Tapi biayanya Bapak Ibu, it's very terjangkau. It's 1/4 of the cost of the world. And then there is the system of education is not theory, but it's a good combination of theory and practice. One important thing, Bapak Ibu, is the books. Bapak Ibu, pasti tahu di India, books mahal sekali ya, Bapak Ibu. It's very expensive, the books in India. But I can tell you in India, the books are very, very affordable. I mean, and that's why many institutions, they insist, kalau masuk ke class, harus bawa buku. So that is what is the benefit. Karena ilmunya, Bapak Ibu, itu bukan dari PowerPoint. Tapi ilmunya adalah dari buku. And the cost of books in India is very cheap. For example, Bapak Ibu, kalau harga buku di Indonesia itu 100.000 atau mungkin maaf 1 juta, buku sama Bapak Ibu yang bisa dapat di India cuma 100.000. Dan itu buku yang asli Bapak Ibu, itu bukan yang fotokopi. Jadi itu adalah yang hebatnya di India Bapak Ibu. The medium of delivery in India is 100% in English. State of the art infrastructure because we have theory and practice. And that's why Bapak Ibu, today in India, a lot of multinational companies, a lot of Fortune 500 companies, they recruit students from India. And I can tell you, hampir 95% of the students, they get a job before graduation. And that shows the competitiveness, that shows the quality of Indian education in India, Bapak Ibu. And that's why you see a lot of CEOs from multinational companies in the field of IT, medicine, engineering are all from India. Ini Bapak Ibu, this is the first university of the world which was established in the year 700 BC. It was called Takshila University. And also Bapak Ibu, India and Indonesia, when it comes to education is not new. If you look at the history, there was something called as a Ruta Ilmu or the knowledge route, which existed between India and Indonesia. But then we do not know why this knowledge route disappeared. The knowledge route existed between Sriwijaya Universitas yang ada di Palembang dengan Takshila University, which was the first university of the world. Bapak Ibu pasti kenal sama Ruta Sutra atau the Silk Route. We all remember that, but we have not heard about the knowledge route which existed between India and Indonesia, Bapak Ibu. Now, these are some of the CEOs, Bapak Ibu. They are all Indians, but they are the CEOs of multinational companies around the world, like from Nokia, from Adobe Systems, PepsiCo, Microsoft, Herman, MasterCard. These are few, Bapak Ibu, but many of them are CEOs from India, Bapak Ibu. Also, we have many world leaders, Bapak Ibu, who are actually the world leaders from different countries, but they are alumni from Indian education. And that again shows the quality, Bapak Ibu, of Indian education. Over here. So we have the world leader from Burma, Afghanistan, Malawi, Nigeria, Bangladesh, Iran, Tanzania, Bhutan. They're all alumni from Indian education. Also, Baba Ibu, we have many Nobel laureates from India. We have a Nobel laureate in the field of literature, in the field of science, in the field of physiology, peace, chemistry, and so on. So again, Baba Ibu, with all respect, unfortunately from Indonesia, we still don't have a Nobel laureate. Now that is something we need to know. The caliber and the the skill sets what India provides. Also, Bapak Ibu, India bukan cuma negara untuk Bollywood, tapi kita juga is a land of invention. Kalau kita pakai flash disk, itu dari India. Yoga, Bapak Ibu, comes from India. Shampoo, what we use, kita pakai di rambut, that comes from India. Catur, chess is something we play all over, all in Indonesia is very common, Bapak Ibu. Again, that comes from India. Fiber optic, plastic surgery, number zero, or the number zero, which we feel has no value, but every computer works on that number zero. It again has been invented in India, Bapak Ibu. Also, Bapak Ibu, if you look at these companies, these are all multinational companies. Like you have Google, which is from America. You have Nokia, which is from Finland. You have Deutsche Bank, which is from German. And you have Microsoft from US. All these are multinational companies, Bapak Ibu. But their CEOs are from India. Again, They are CEOs from India and they are graduates from Indian education. That shows the quality, Bapa Ibu, of Indian education. Also, Bapa Ibu, kita ada banyak university. We also have many Indian companies which are multinational all over the world and also in Indonesia, Bapa Ibu. Pasti Bapa Ibu udah kenal sama Tata. We have Tata which sells mobile, ya Bapa Ibu, the Indonesia. We have TVS which yang jual moped. We also have Himalaya, Bapa Ibu. Kalau Bapa Ibu ke mall dan ke apotek, you will see Himalaya. And all these are few companies which are Indian companies, but having presence all over the world, including Indonesia, Bapa Ibu. Now, Bapa Ibu, India is one of the country which is the largest English-speaking country in the world. Now, this is something, Bapa Ibu, which is very important untuk siswa-siswi kita, karena bahasa yang kerja adalah bahasa Inggris, Bapa Ibu. Now, di Indonesia, Bapa Ibu, sebenarnya menurut saya, karena udah 20 tahun tinggal di Indonesia, menurut saya siswa-siswi kita sebenarnya bisa omong bahasa Inggris. Cuman kekurangan mereka adalah lingkungan ya Bapak Ibu, karena orang tua nggak bisa ngomong bahasa Inggris karena turunannya dari Belanda. Tapi India Bapak Ibu karena turunan dari English atau Inggris, that's why all Indians can speak English. And the focus Bapak Ibu is not on the grammar, but the focus is on communication. Dan kita ada banyak siswa-siswi Bapak Ibu yang udah pernah dari Indonesia ke India, sebelumnya mereka ragu untuk ngomong bahasa Inggris. Tapi setelah mereka lihat orang bajai yang omong bahasa Inggris tanpa grammar yang bagus, tapi fokusnya ke komunikasi, mereka senang sekali Bapak Ibu, dan mereka juga udah mulai, mereka percaya diri, dan mereka juga udah mulai omong bahasa Inggris Bapak Ibu. Jadi ini ada kesempatan Bapak Ibu. Now also Bapak Ibu, India, kita, we feel India is a developing country. But the yang lucu Bapak Ibu adalah India is a country which assist or which helps developed countries like US, UK, Germany, France, to send their satellite to the space station. Karena India has the same technology as the other countries, but with the cost only 10%, Bapa Ibu. Just 10% of the cost. So that's the beauty, Bapa Ibu. Now, India juga, Bapa Ibu, sekarang adalah yang keunggulan di India adalah di bidang perobatan, di bidang IT, computer, engineering, teknik, management, business, media, dan lain-lain. Dan ini ada beberapa Bapak Ibu that India bukan cuma untuk pendidikan tapi untuk jalan-jalan juga Bapak Ibu. It's a beautiful place. It has rich culture, it has rich tradition and architectures very similar to Indonesia Bapak Ibu. Indonesia also is beautiful and so is India. Then also Bapak Ibu, we have many places in India which are very similar around the world. Like we have the Gulmarg which is similar to Switzerland. We have that Gorondangmar Lake which is similar to the US. We also have Andaman Island, which is similar to Thailand. We also have Lakshadweep, which is similar to Maldives. Rann of Kutch, Gujarat, which is actually where the where Marwari University is. We also have, which is very similar to the Bonneville Salt Flats. We have the Valley of Flowers in Uttarakhand, which is similar to the Antelope Valley in the US. We also have falls. We also have Gurung, yeah, Bapa Ibu. We also have a desert called Thar Desert, which is similar to the Sahara Desert. We have beaches, we have mountains, ada gunung. Karena Bapak Ibu, kalau kita lihat, India adalah sebenarnya continent. Tapi because it is in Asia, di buku geography kita selalu tersebut as a subcontinent, Bapak Ibu. Dan juga Bapak Ibu, India also has rich tradition and belief. Kita ada satu acara namanya Festival of Holi. We also have Eid, ya Bapak Ibu, yang Idul Fitri. We also celebrate Idul Fitri in India. We have Diwali, we have Christmas, and also we have a place called River Ganga. Itu hampir sama seperti yang haji ya Bapak Ibu untuk orang-orang Islam yang di Indonesia. And also Bapak Ibu, ini adalah many people think semua orang India, every Indian looks like a Shah Rukh Khan, which is not true Bapak Ibu. India, same as Indonesia, we are very diverse. And this gives you an example of how the people look very different. The dress code is different. Our language is different, and even our food habits are different, Bapa Ibu. And Bapa Ibu, if you look at number lima, the fifth one, now this person or this child is actually from Northeast, and they look very much like the Chinese, Bapa Ibu. But believe me, they have Indian passport. So what I'm trying to say is, it is very, very similar, Bapa Ibu. I mean, India is very similar to Indonesia. We are very diverse, and it's a huge, and it's very strong in culture. And makanan Bapak Ibu, nasi or rice is very common in India, especially in South India. Yang utara, they love to eat chapati or roti ya Bapak Ibu. Atau Bapak Ibu pasti kenal sama roti canai. Also Bapak Ibu, ini mungkin Bapak Ibu belum tahu. India is the world's second largest Muslim populated country in the world. With a population of almost 180 million people, Bapak Ibu. Jadi yang penduduk orang Islam di seluruh dunia yang nomor pertama adalah di India. Dan nomor dua, Bapak Ibu, adalah Indonesia. So that means India is a secular country and the culture is very similar, Bapak Ibu. Jadi kalau siswa-siswi kita mau ikutin ibadah yang sama, mau makan halal, itu gampang, Bapak Ibu. It's very easy because it's the same as Indonesia in India. Now, Bapak Ibu, now with the quality of education, with the similarities of the culture, the cost of living, Bapak Ibu, is in India, just for information, is 2 juta per bulan. Dan itu udah termasuk tempat tinggal di asrama. It is in the staying in a hostel. Itu udah termasuk tempat tinggal di asrama. Udah termasuk makanan 3 kali, Bapak Ibu. Dan itu udah termasuk makanan pagi, sarapan, udah termasuk makan siang, dan itu udah termasuk makan malam, Bapak Ibu. Dan itu termasuk snacks yang dan juga udah termasuk cuci baju dan gosok semua biaya itu Bapak Ibu itu hitungannya 2 juta per bulan. Dan cuman untuk informasi Bapak Ibu itu makanannya bukan nasi goreng tek-tek ya Bapak Ibu, itu adalah makanan yang bagus tapi biayanya cuma 2 juta per bulan dengan kualitas seperti yang tadi kita sampaikan. Dan the biaya tuition fee Bapak Ibu atau biaya kuliah adalah untuk non technical program Bapak Ibu itu adalah 15 sampai 25 juta per tahun dan untuk program teknik adalah 25 sampai 50 juta per tahun Bapak Ibu. Itu hampir sama kalau saya bilang hampir sama seperti universitas swasta di Indonesia Bapak Ibu. And this is just an information Bapak Ibu kalau mau belajar di India itu adalah sistem apa student visa dan biayanya adalah 1,2 juta untuk 5 tahun atau 3 tahun tergantung periode pelajarannya Bapak Ibu. The benefits atau keuntungan Bapak Ibu, India and Indonesia are not far, we are maritime neighbors, then the cultures are very similar Bapak Ibu. Kita hampir sama, we are very very similar to the cultures. The study benefits, quality education, affordable cost Bapak Ibu karena bukunya murah dan itu biaya itu belajarnya bukan cuma dari teori tapi ada praktek Bapak Ibu dan makanya ada 95% siswa mereka dapat kerja sebelum lulus. Now undergraduate program atau S1 Bapak Ibu itu adalah 3 tahun untuk program non teknik jadi mereka bisa untung 1 tahun. Now another important point Bapak Ibu pasti siswa-siswi kita yang mereka senang sekali adalah yang skripsi. Karena kita ada sistemnya turunan dari Inggris untuk S1 gak ada skripsi. Mereka tetap dibikin research proposal, mereka tapi gak ada sidang. Jadi itu proses sidang tidak ada Bapak Ibu, tapi researchnya tetap dibikinkan. Dan mereka juga bisa kerja untuk part-time, mereka bisa. Dan juga kita ada PPI Bapak Ibu, ada Persatuan Pelajar Indonesia di India. Dan juga sekarang kita ada banyak perusahaan-perusahaan India yang ada di Indonesia. Jadi untuk kesempatan untuk kerja juga ada ya Bapak Ibu untuk informasinya. Now these are our contact details. Terima kasih banyak Bapak Ibu. Terima kasih, syukriya. Thank you so much. Maaf Bapak Ibu, saya agak cepat. I was a little bit quick. I was going through it very fast because the focus is not on India and Indian education, but the focus is on the webinar. But we just wanted to give some quick information about India and Indian education. Thank you so much Bapak Ibu. Thank you Dhananjay sir. The screen is yours sir.
Thank you very much. All right, so I would say namaste to all the participants again, and please pardon me, I had given some assignment yesterday and you had to do it because I firmly believe that learning is going to be a messy business. Messy business means just like kitchen, when you are preparing your food, the food looks very messy, but once it is prepared and served on a fine bone china crockery set, then it becomes beautiful. So we are, learning is actually the messy business. The first time when you will record your video, the video will not come as per your expectation, but it will take retake, and then you will find out the final one. And Harvard research says that the videos are the best medium, best way, because it gives you immediate feedback, the instant feedback on your performance. And that is how we need to learn. In fact, if I talk about my department here, learning and development at Marwari University, we have the mandate to train the faculty members in teaching learning. We don't do any other business. We have only the process to train the teachers how to teach to the students. So we have the levels of faculty development program. And this we are doing very basic, very fundamental level, the psychological level of the teachers. We have the other programs where we use the technology, how to use the Zoom and Canvas effectively to deliver your lectures and maintain, manage the learning for the students. So this is about the learning and development vertical. Little bit about my university also I would like to play. And three things I have to share. Number one, when you are joining, when you are leaving, all it is being recorded by Zoom. And please join by your first name and your last name when you join at the time of joining this workshop, because that is also getting collected. And at the time of issuing the certificate, that would be very, very important information for us. So I saw that some of you are joining by the name of your mobile handset. Some of you are joining by the computer name. Some of you are joining by your email ID directly. So please make sure that wherever it is said that first name, your first name should appear and your last name should appear and what name you want to be on the certificate. Because one error in the name in the certificate and the certificate becomes invalid. So be very particular about your name on the certificate, what you want to be there. At the same time, I would also say that there are participants, those who are raising hands. If you have something, please type in the chat box. We are not able to see an eye because the number is very high. Almost 400 plus people are there on this platform. So if you have anything, I will request my colleague, Mr. Noorali Chamadia. He's also eagerly waiting today to keep an eye on the chat box. But I will take next 10 minutes about the yesterday's or day before yesterday, the assignment which I had given. I had given two assignments. The first one was you need to create your own YouTube channel and record your videos and upload the video there, because the YouTube has become the second largest search engine today on the internet. Any student whom you are teaching may go tomorrow and they search for you. So you need to have your own YouTube channel. So sharing the content, the best medium is YouTube. So anything, any explanatory thing you want, any lecture you want, you can record your lecture, upload it on the YouTube and share with your students at their own pace, own place. They can go through and watch and attend the lecture. That is the technology we are using and we call it the flip learning.
Sir, sorry, there's some comments, sir, to please speak a bit slowly, sir, if you don't mind. Sorry, thank you.
Okay. Yesterday I was very slow, so I thought let me increase my number.
Yes, sir. So, sure. Thank you, sir. Okay. Thank you.
So the point which I'm making is that YouTube is very, very important platform to share the content with the audience, with your students. Any student whom you are teaching, they love to see his or her teacher in action. So we call it flip learning. You know what happens? See, what currently the traditional method of teaching is the teacher teaches in the class, lecture is happening in the class, an assignment and homework is given for home, where no teacher is available, only parents are there. Sometimes parents are not educated and the homework and assignment takes a lot of cognitive exercises. So what this flip learning says that you flip it. You give the lecture online to them. You record your lecture online and put it there on the YouTube. They will watch it at their home. And when they come in the class, they will do the assignment exercise and practice question. And that is how the cognitive learning takes place. So that is called the flip learning, which we teach, which we train our faculty members here. So there are a lot of content, a lot of technologies to teach and use the pedagogies. Maybe when we get time later in future, we can also showcase some of them. Oh, I'm very happy. The followers are 2,150. So look at that. I must clap for you. You have a YouTube channel, wonderful YouTube channel, you say. So great. So we need to promote this. We need to promote to all the teaching community, because YouTube has become the best platform for teaching any subject. And YouTube is the best place to learn any subject in the world. So keeping this in mind, I will just repeat what we had done yesterday. Before I hand over, we invite Noorali. He's getting up. I would say that yesterday we talked about Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, which is the birthplace, and Rajkot is the place where he had studied, and he completed his elementary education at Rajkot, and we are proudly there. Then we talked about Sudha Murthy, $1.92 billion worth lady. She bowed down to her teacher because she gave the entire credit to her success to her teacher. So you are at a very, very important role. You are going to be the model like Sudha Murthy. Some Sudha Murthy may be in your class tomorrow. The third thing, the air hostess story, we had to drive the point that only content is not important, but you also have to tell the context of it, because when you give the content and context, then it becomes useful for learning and learning takes place. And we also discussed the learning is experience. Unless people experience, learning does not take place. And to experience something, you need to reflect. Reflection. So there's a framework also for reflection. We call it reflective framework. What, so what, and now what? So whenever you do something, look at that, what you did. Then how did you feel while doing that? And what next? So what, so what, and now what? You can Google it later. I'll drop the link. That is called the reflection framework. Anything when you do, learning by doing, and then reflection must take place. So we discussed about it. The learning by doing, learning by experience, and experience requires reflection. And the next point which we had, that was the three V's of communication: vocal, visual, and verbal. And that was given by Mehrabian, Albert Mehrabian, after a study of 10 years research on the nonverbal communication. Maybe people may differ, people may disagree by his quantifying things, like he says 55% visual, 28% non-vocal, and 7% verbal. People may disagree. I'm not saying that it is religiously true. But the point is that largely the visual is more dominating when it comes to communication. That people will agree. And that is what, that was my next exercise which I had given you. There was a paragraph given where the direction is given by somebody and you had to travel to that. And then based on that paragraph, you had to answer some questions. And I'm sure it is very difficult to answer. I don't know about you, but when I attempted it, it was difficult for me to answer. But I will show you how it can be quickly very easy because of the Mehrabian theory. He said that visuals are very, very important. So I will take a snapshot of yesterday's assignment which I had given to you. And then the last thing which we had, that was the Dublin's girl. She hated so much their teachers that she said one sentence to the demolishing company, that please demolish my school and make sure that all my teachers are in. So are we going to be a model like that? So we need to reshape, we need to look at our set of skills and see teaching, learning, teaching, learning, teaching, learning. This word, wherever comes in the world, in any dictionary, any academic record you see, both these words come together. Academic hyphen learn, I mean, teaching hyphen learning, which means teacher also have to learn. Teaching and learning, both are on the same continuum. So teaching, learning, teaching, learning, teaching, learning. It never says that teaching and learning, teaching and learning, teaching and learning. No. And it also does not say that teaching, 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 teaching only. So teachers also have to learn. So please spare some time for your learning as well. And that is the endeavor for this week we are doing here on Marwari University virtually. And this, let me present this assignment which I was talking about quickly, and then today's session we will take. Is my screen visible to all of you? Please give me a signal.
Yes, sir.
All right. So a small clip I have from my university, I would just play it. I'll just again. This is the university where I'm currently speaking from. So have a look on this university, world-class infrastructure here in Rajkot.
I'm Angelo and I'm from Mozambique. I'm currently doing engineering in my university. The first time I came to India, I met a lot of people and I found out that Indian people are so friendly. They're helping me in each and every task. Through my friends, I learned a little bit of the Indian culture. Now I can consider myself discovering the Indian culture through my university.
Sultan from Syria. I'm studying in my university in India. I feel like home with other Syrian students and Indian students. They are so lovely and friendly.
I'm Somji. I'm from Bhutan. I discovered the world of books in my university.
I'm John Paul, I'm from Uganda. We discovered our fitness goals at our university.
Enefukia Oluzolo from Congo. I've been playing basketball, and when I joined my university here in India, I got better and better after days of work. Here in my university, you discover yourself.
Hi, I'm Rati Madhikami from Nepal. I'm a computer engineering student. I'm so happy to experience a world-class education in my university. Here, the lecturers are very wonderful, and also they are willing to take time from me to discuss about my future goals. I'm discovering myself here.
I'm Rohini Shashikala from Sri Lanka. I'm discovering new life skills in my university.
So this is a little bit about the university where 35 countries, students from 35 different countries are studying today, and they are making their friendship in 35 countries. Imagine how will be the scenario. One student who passes out from Marwari University and he claims and he says that I have my friends in 35 different countries in the world. How will be his future and what will be the future of the world? That is why we say that this is the amazing opportunity for any student to learn. Now, the next thing which I have, am I audible to all of you? Raviji, am I audible, visible on my screen?
Yes, sir.
Everything going well?
Yes, sir. All well, sir.
All right. So this was the assignment which I had given yesterday. I had given one paragraph to read. And please let me know in the chat box how many of you did find it easy. If you found it easy, say yes. Very easy. And the assignment was, there is a direction given by somebody. It says, hi, here is the direction. From the airport, take the road that leads out of the rental lot and follow it past the barrier around the
lot. They're not able to hear you very clearly, sir. Maybe the microphone, if you don't mind, sir.
Am I audible? I'm using the USB microphone, the best microphone possible.
Okay.
Maybe their internet connectivity, because today I have got the privilege of using high-speed internet also for the delivery, because yesterday it was a little slow. Is internet connectivity a problem? Maybe at their end. My system is running completely fine here. Maybe I'm a little fast today because I have to quickly finish it and before I start the session today. Shall I go a little slow, Praviji? You tell me.
Sir, thoda slow, sir. Hanji, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So I just wanted you to go through this paragraph yesterday, which I had given you. And my question is that it was quite confusing, quite difficult for many, many people. In fact, when I attempted first time just by reading this paragraph and trying to attempt the question, it was also very challenging for me. And I'm sure it must have been for everybody. And that is what the Mehrabian theory is. I just want to qualify the Mehrabian theory by this particular exercise. I did not give this exercise just for your reading comprehension test or any kind of assessment. No. I wanted to qualify the statement made by Mehrabian, where he says that visual is the most dominant part of communication when you communicate something to somebody. We also discussed yesterday the communication has a cycle. When I communicate something to somebody and when I receive a feedback from their end, if they are following me and they are responding me the way I wanted them to respond, then my communication is successful. If it is not happening that way, then communication failed. So in this paragraph, I gave you, and there were seven questions. And the questions goes like this. Where is the parking lot? Where are the rental cars? What do you have to pass to get out of the parking lot? What do you see just before the road wheels out of the parking lot? After the second fork, what do you watch for? And do you go over or under the viaduct? And which highway do you take? This is the question based on this paragraph. But it is so confusing. It actually creates more confusion for the participant. Now, if I put simply a visual here, and then you tell me, is it the same level of difficulty or it became simpler? Here it is. Now just have a look on this picture. and try to answer the questions. And then both these feelings, I wanted to make you feel earlier yesterday when you were given this task and tried to attempt the question, and today when I'm showing you this picture and trying to attempt the question, which one is easier and which one is more powerful, you will feel in your heart and you will tell me. Now there is the picture given here and the question, where is the parking lot? You can see here is the parking lot. Where? Next to the rental lots, the rental car. Where are the rental cars? Beside the parking lot. What do you have to get through to parking lot? Look at that. This is entire, it will not take more than 30 seconds to answer all these seven questions if this visual is present. But if this visual was not present yesterday, it might have taken hours, but still you could have not figured out the right answer for these seven questions. That is what the Mehrabian theory is. So even in your online classes also, try to put as much visuals as possible. Visuals means, yesterday somebody was asking a question. Visual means the pictures, the videos, the drawing, some kind of language which is also vivid. You know, the language also can create the visuals. When you speak and when you narrate the finer details of the elements of the things, it also creates the visual image in the mind of the listener. So that is where yesterday we stopped. And now today we are going to take you forward about the role of teachers. Yesterday we ended with the Dublin girl, what not to do. So there are many more things what to do. Now we will hear, invite the next man in the picture, my colleague, Nurali Chamadia. He's an amazing trainer, wonderful trainer. Let's go ahead with him. Over to Nurali, screen is yours.
Thank you very much, sir. Am I audible and clear to you? And to all of you, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Great, it is a wonderful platform. I would like to thank all of you for making this possible at the university. We are really very happy to connect with you. So in a moment, I'll just share my screen and let me know whether my screen is visible. And I have a special way. When you want to communicate, when you want to answer, what you can do is, when you want to say yes, I don't want yes once. I want yes twice. So when the slide appears to you on your screen, what you need to do is, you need to type yes, yes two times so I understand that yes, it is visible and clear for all of you. Sir, I need the screen sharing option. Thank you, sir. So friends, tell me whether the slide is visible to all of you. Is there something missing in the slide? Oh, you can type it. If you find something is missing, you can type it and tell me. What do you see on the screen? Is there anything missing? Because I want you to be up and awake. Yes, fantastic. You spotted it. E is missing. Where did the E go? I told you, where did the E go? So do you think teachers have a little bit of ego in them? And that ego has to go when you embrace this profession of teaching? And there is no place for ego when it comes to the profession of teaching. There is no place for, as we say, these are some rhyming words, teaching, then it comes cheating, then it comes itching, then it comes preaching. So there is no scope, there is no room, there is no place for all these things. And that's what I would like to say. The first thing is, there is no ego. E should go, E must go, and there has to be no ego when it comes to teaching and learning. Because we are not 100% perfect. We strive to be, we want to be. Every moment is a moment for learning. Every moment is an opportunity. Every time when you take that book in your hand And when you join this profession of teaching or when you enter the class, this thing must go in your mind. There is no place for ego. Agreed? Yes, yes. If you are in agreement with me, you can type yes, yes, so that I can move ahead quickly forward, because we have so many things and I want to talk so many things with all of you. I'm really very happy with your participation. I can see all the yes, yes appearing very quickly. That's fantastic. So now the E will appear. What do we mean by welcome? When we say something, we definitely mean by that. So what do we mean by that? When? I want you to read it out. And that's what we mean. When you enter the space of online Marwari University space, online space, make sure one thing we can guarantee is that learning is fun and your cooperation is expected. And our positive attitude, I mean to say our, not only yours, our positive attitude and mutual respect will be a part of everything in whatever we do and we say. Agreed? So we will have to cooperate each other, and I will make learning fun for today. I will make sure that you do so many things. So are you ready to go? The first task of the day is coming on the screen, because in this session, what we are going to do is we will be doing in-class tasks and out-of-the-class tasks also. There will be in-class activity and out-of-the-class activity, and you all must do that. And your certificates will depend upon that, if I can use that word, Dhananjay sir.
Yes, yes, it is.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So the task appearing on the screen, what will be the task look like? There will be 4 or 5 lines written in English. It is a kind of an exercise, an activity, 5 to 6 lines written in English. What you have to do is you have to calculate the number of F in it. And I repeat, calculate the number of F, quantify, calculate, find out whether there is 1F, 2F, 3F, 4F, 5F, whatever is your answer. But I repeat, do not type your answers in the chat box. No, no, no typing of the answers in the chat box. Agreed? If you are in agreement with me, you can type yes, yes once again. Not once, you will have to type yes, yes, twice. Thank you very much. Great. Thank you very much. Now the task will appear. Oh, so many yes. Fabulous. Thank you very much. More is always better. We all teachers would like to have more things. So this is the agenda. The agenda, I tell you, this is what we are looking at in a nutshell. But let me come to the task first and I'll go back to the agenda. This is the disclaimer that we have. We don't intend to use any marketing material. We are giving due credit and full credit to the makers. And the exercise is now on your screen. Count, it will stay only for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, it will go and the link will come on the screen where you are supposed to go and vote. So it is now on your screen. It will stay only for 10 seconds. Count, do not type anything in the chat box. 5 seconds has gone. Yes. Boom, it goes. And there is a link on your screen. I want you all to go to this link and You can use this code. Do not type anything over there in the chat box. Please do not type anything in the chat box. Go to this link, which says www.menti.com, and give me your answers.
So the question is, they have to say the number of F's, right, sir? How many
yes,
F's?
Yeah. They have to tell me the number of F. And you have to give this answer in the link. You will have to use this code. I will type the code again for you. And I want to see everybody participating. Every one of you must answer this question. Only 17 people so far have voted. You need to buck up. You need to pick it up. 23, 24. I will keep it open only for 30 seconds, not more than that. Because we have so many tasks.
Bapaibu, please do this on your respective laptops or on your phone. Please. Thank you.
We have received so far 65, 67. Dhananjay sir, I hope the screen is visible.
It is visible.
Yeah. Okay. So I would like to now close it and see what is the answer that people have given. I would like to share with you also. This is what the answer has been given to me. And majority of the people say 35%, 36% of the people say that the answer is 4, 30% 6, 14% 7, and around 19 to 20% say, yes, it is 8. Okay. Thank you very much for your participation. Participation is still going, but now we need to come back to what we were talking. Thank you very much for your participation. I'm really very happy. Thank you very much for your participation. Okay, we are back to the screen, and you'll be wondering what is the right answer, isn't it? Would you like to know the right answer? So I will not give you the answer. Learning happens only when the learner does something. That's what we learned in the previous session. So what I'll do is I will again give you an opportunity to take a look at what answers you have given, and I will flash it again. This was the paragraph which was shared with you. It has 6 lines, and we were to calculate the number of F in it. And you gave me the answer. So I want you to once again look at it.
And those who had said that 4, 6, 8, 5, I think they all can prove each other that they are correct.
correct. So you need to, you can type now. Whatever number comes to your mind, you can type in the chat box, and you can tell me still what is according to you the answer.
So ethic says 4. So if we are giving the opportunity ethic to prove others, he will prove that there are 4 F only. He's so confident.
Great. Still, so many people are saying 7. So many people are saying 4, 6. Great. Some of them are saying 8. But I want you to read the lines carefully and see the F properly and come to an answer which is the right answer. And let me take you back to the result. I will stop this for a moment. I'll take you back to the screen earlier, which I had shared about your participation. And you see, now we have about 161 and the percentages have also changed. So what I'll do is I'll press the enter and you will come to know the right answer. Then again, you will have to go to the presentation screen and find out whether the answer is correct or not. Because we all are teachers, we need to prove whether the answer is correct or not.
So one thing I want to check with Ravi ji, F is written like F in Indonesia also, na?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Highest number are saying 4.
Okay, great. So I will press the enter and the correct answer will remain in bold. Rest all will get faded. Now the screen says the right answer is 8. 18% of the people who participated gave the right answer and 29 people gave the right answer. And look at the number who gave the wrong answers. We are all teachers. We all have the task of only 5 to 6 lines and we had only one letter to count. Alphabet has so many letters, but then we had only zeroed in on one letter, that is F, and we were to count the number of F. For 10 seconds, slide appeared. We gave you another opportunity also, and look at this. What I do is again share my presentation screen, and I'll give you an opportunity to prove whether the answer is correct or not. Take some time and see whether you are able to see 8 F's in it or not. And in the meantime, I would also request all of you, whether you are now able to see 8 F in it. And if yes, tell me, why did this mistake happen? Why? So many people gave 4, 6, 7,
in fact, there are some those who are bent on 6 only. Yes, they are confident that 6 only.
So I will now point out the F's in the first line. How many F's you can see in the first line? Starts with fun, ends with fun. How many F? Come on. How many F? 2. Very good, Rizana. Very good. 2. Fantastic. How many F's in the second line? In the second line, 1, great. How many F's in the third line? Great. How many in the fourth line? Great. How many in the fifth line? And what is the total? What is the total? We all counted all the lines and the total has to be 8. Yes, exactly. So why did this mistake happen is the question that I want to ask to all of you. Why did this simple task, why did this mistake happen? Any one reason you could give to me, you can type it in the chat box. But I have the answer. I can tell you why we all did make the mistake. If you see, we all would have skipped this number. We would have skipped this smaller letter or say small word, which is off. We would have skipped that word. That's tricky word. Yes. No visuals again. Yes. There is a visual in front of you. There are 6 lines. Yes, it requires focus. Skimming through. We generally tend to skim through We don't take into account the smaller words. We skim through. We are always in a hurry. We are in a haste. When we have a task, we want to complete this. It requires focus. It requires proper attention. So whatever answers you are giving me, are these answers relevant to your profession of teaching? That's what is required in teaching.
Sorry, sir, just to come in between. Dhananjay, sir, the YouTube people are not able to see the video. I mean, they're not able to see the broadcast. Could you just recheck on that, sir, please? Thank you. Mr. Noor. Sorry, sir.
Yeah, no problem. No problem.
It is live there on my screen. I'm able to see both are running parallelly. Maybe the same link yesterday, the link which I had shared, the same link will be accessible. It is running up there on the YouTube. I can see on the screen.
It's working, right, sir? Then I'll just reinforce on from that, from this side.
I'll show you on the screen itself. It is running.
Sure, sir. No issues. I'll just reinforce, sir. No worries, sir. Sure. Thank you.
Shall I continue, sir?
Yeah, please.
Yes, please, sir. Please.
Thank you very much. So many answers you have given, and these all answers are relevant to our teaching. Yes, we need the focus. We saw the timeline is always limited when we are in this profession. We have so many things to do. Timeline is always short, but it requires a lot of accuracy. It requires a lot of focus. It requires a lot of attention when it comes to the learner, when it comes to the learning. And that's where the learning happens. And we always need to go back and reflect how we are doing our job. What made us to do this job and how we are doing this job. And similarly, when we do some task, we need to again go back and see how we have done the task. Is there any scope of improvement? Can I change it to better? And that's where all the lines and learnings will appear. So that's what I wanted to tell you with the small activity. I hope you had enjoyed with this activity. If you have enjoyed, you can type yes, yes. And that's what I mean to say. It's the little details that are vital. Little things make big things happen. All small, little things. And I'm telling you, there are going to be so many activities in the session. It's not going to be one way me speaking and you just listening. It's not going to happen like that. We will ask you to do so many things. Last time we saw about 200 people participating. I want more participation for you from you in the next activity. Do you agree with me that you will give more participation in the next activity?
I can see the teachers being the students. Now they are complaining that it is too fast. It was this time you gave. And that is how the students complain also when we give them a question paper.
Correct.
So correct. It is very unique to see the teachers becoming a student.
Yes. And Dhananjay sir, that is a very interesting point that you're bringing, that we often tend to neglect those complaints. We often tend to oversee, and there are so many things which are running at the back of your mind when it comes to the task, and we don't check whether the task is there, relevant to them, appealing to them. It is hard, it is easy. And that's where we started bang on. We said that in teaching, E should go, that ego should go. We should be ready to learn. We should be ready to reflect. And we should check it also whether we were right or not. And we should accept if we have made any mistake. And yes, we all make mistakes. Yes, we all falter in small little tasks. So when our children falter, when our kids falter, when our students falter, it is our job, it is our role that we need to show the compassion. We need to have that understanding. We need to be more and more compassionate towards this profession and towards the pupils and towards the learner. That is what the simple thing I want to tell you. And all these small little things take account for big things. And these are very, very important lessons of life. That's what I learned. To tell you all, when I did first time this activity, I counted only 6 F. I tell you, I was able to count only 6. I was not able to give you the right answer. I made a mistake, but it taught me so many things. So when you make a mistake, there is one lesson to learn, and we don't repeat that mistake, or neither we forget that lesson. That's what I would like to tell you. So going back to the agenda that we flashed, we are looking for teaching, decoding teaching as a profession, we are also taking a look at essentials. What are the essentials in teaching? And we are looking at the role of a teacher in this session. And now we are moving ahead. And I request your continuous participation, cooperation, and positive attitude throughout the session. Let me ask you once again, are you all happy? Because it is very important. In teaching, you need to be very, very happy. When you go to the class, you need to have that happy state of mind, because we are not happy, then we are not going to make people happy. And teaching is making people happy. Your teaching should make people happy. And the happy word has two P in it. One P stands for positivity. Another P stands for patience. A teacher may not, should not, must not lose the two P's in it. One is patience. Another is, you can type it. If you have listened carefully, you'll be able to type it. If you are happy teaching, are you happy? One is patience, another is positivity, the positive frame of mind.
In fact, one point, Nuruli, I would like to bring here.
Please, sir.
These are all English teachers. And if I say one sentence called, I teach, it is not the complete sentence.
Yes.
I teach English to students, which means I need to know about myself, my mood, my psychological state. I teach. I also need to way to teach the pedagogy of teaching.
Yes.
English, definitely, that is, I'm the subject matter expert, English.
Yes.
And I also need to know student.
Yes.
So I teach English or any subject to students. So I need to know about myself, I, students, psychology, when in what mood they are in, when they are happy, when they are not happy. So that is going to be complete sentence. So
that fabulous. Fabulous, sir. Clap for sir for bringing this very interesting point here. We need to take a note of this. I would be very happy if you keep a notepad and pen with you, and if you just pin down those points which are appealing or which are interesting or which makes us really think. Because one of my teacher told me that thinking is the core duty of a teacher, and thinking is something which has to be transferred by the teacher to the pupil, the ability to think. Because the thinking word has the king word in it. If you can note, thinking word has the king word in it. So you become king when you think, when you start to, it is in a continuous tense, we say thinking. So you only stay as king as long as you think. Because thinking is what we make our students learn. What is, how to think. Yes, that's very important.
Yeah, in fact, wonderful point made by Anugraha, I think. He says that I learn English with my students. So I clap for him. Wonderful.
Yeah.
He put it,
yeah.
I don't teach, but I learn
with
my
students.
Great.
Exactly. So it's our duty to make them think, to give them assortments, to give them materials, to give them things in which they can think. And if we are doing that, then I suppose we are doing a great job when it comes to teaching. But remember two things I started with. There is no ego, and there has to be a happy state of mind. Happy state has two P's in it. One is patience, another is positivity. So I want you to do another task. Think for a moment about the teacher who made the difference in your life, whom you loved a lot, who is your favorite teacher. Think about that teacher, and the picture will definitely come right in front of your mind. Think about the teacher who has made an impact in your life, or your favorite teacher, and describe one good quality of that teacher, not here in the chat box. No, not here in the chat box. We will give you the link. In that link, you are supposed to answer. Clear? Are you ready for this task? I am going to give you the link. And in that link, you are supposed to answer the simple question, which is on the slide. Think about your favorite teacher. describe one good quality, only one word I want, one word of the teacher whom you remember. Give me a moment, I will give you the link. Do not type your answers here, and you can type that one word in the link which is shared with you. What is one word that comes to your mind when it comes to your favorite teacher? I have already shared with the link with all of you. I hope you would have received.
Sorry, sir. Dhananjay, sir, if you don't mind, mereko WhatsApp karenge, sir, wo link ka, because wo previous link is coming of the previous session, sir. The recorded session link aa raha hai uspe. So I'm not able to hear you, sorry. No, I think you're muted, sir.
I dropped it here in the chat box also.
Yeah.
So this is the link where you are supposed to go and answer. Please, yeah, I have shared with you the link. Due to the internet connectivity, I suppose it should have reached. Whether the link has reached to the students?
Yeah, actually the problem is it is not coming as a link because we have to write HTTPS. So the whole, then only it will come as a link. Www okay. will not come.
Okay.
So to copy it and paste it. I'll just copy and paste it. Wait a minute.
Okay.
I'll give the link here and then it will work as a link and they can put the code, but there are some problem they are facing. They are not able to access the link in their, app or in their handphone.
Okay.
Now here is the link.
Okay.
Did you see the link in the chat box?
Yeah, I saw the link.
This will work as a link, hyperlink.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, sir.
Ravi, you got the YouTube link, video link?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I'm just sharing with the others, sir. Thank you.
Sure.
And I suppose all my teachers today, all my fellow teachers today have got this link and have started to participate. And so far I have received around, I would say, 76 people have so far participated. I want the number to touch 200 and we will just give you 30 more seconds to answer and I will flash the result with all of you. You can now see what you are typing is there on the screen and fabulous. My God, 139 and it is counting. It is going on. Inspiring, friendly, patient, all your teachers whom you loved, who was your favorite teacher or who is your favorite teacher. Energetic. Look at the words. Patient. So many people have typed patient and that's why it is big. Interesting is what people have written. Inspiring, fun, funny, so many things. Lovely, energetic, always motivating students. Oh my God, you have written a line also over there. Amazing, compassionate. Oh, so many answers. Look at this, it is going on and I'm sure we are going to touch 200. Thank you very much for the participation here. So by that, what I meant, I wanted to tell you what I meant, because I, according to me, and according to what I think is teaching is one who awakens the creativity in the students, who awakens the thirst and desire for knowledge and expression in our students. It is with the teaching that makes it possible. teacher is the one who ignites the imagination and is the only person who can instill the love of learning in students. Because if your students like learning, that is because of you. And if the students don't like learning, that is probably because of us only. There is no other way out. The curriculum is just a raw material. What we teach our subject, the knowledge is just a raw material to the knowledge. And teacher who brings the lasting impact is because of the warmth, because the ability that they have is to touch. And it is said that to teach is to touch a life forever. And these are the vital elements and the soul of teaching, because it appeals to everybody.
Dhananjay sir, sorry sir, the link which you had given on the YouTube, the video is private, sir. We are not able to open it. Could you recheck that, sir, please, if you don't mind? Thank you.
Shall I continue, sir?
Yeah, please.
Thank you very much. So now we are at a stage, we would like to know who we are as teachers. We know we are as teachers, but what is our worth? What is our power? And what is ideal teaching? These are the three questions that comes to our mind. Yes, a favorite teacher will show you a lot of quality, will have a lot of warmth and will display a lot of understanding. Yes, you are right. All of you have participated beautifully. I would like to say thank you. Thank you very much for your participation. But we all as teachers would like to know what is our power and how we should do our teaching and what is our worth, isn't it? Would you like to know? If you would like to know, you can type yes, yes in the chat box. Yes, great. So far, so many people are ready to know what is our worth, what is ideal teaching, what is the power in teaching. So what I want you to do is, because learner learns something when he or she does it. So what I want to do is, I want to give you an activity. Are you ready for another activity coming up for you? Because you would be doing so many tasks, and tasks will teach you, tasks will make you learn. Are you ready for another activity? Great, great. So first we need to understand what this activity, because it is said that you need to know the rules first if you want to perform better. And to win any game or to participate and to win any game, there is one word in the win, which is in. So to win the game, you have to be in the game first. So be in the game so that you can win the game. So by that, what I mean is participate. And I'm sure when you participate, you will win. Sometimes we win, sometimes we learn, and so many opportunities gets opened for us. So another activity on your screen, if you are able to see the screen, we will give you one link, which I have not given you. Please don't ask me where is the link. I'll give it to you in a moment. But first of all, understand what this activity is all about. Task number two or task number three, we did one task, counting F, second, about our favorite teacher and the quality in the favorite teacher. Third task is coming up on your screen right now, which says go to the link. You will find 24 cue cards. There will be 24 cue cards over there, which I will give it to you. And I want everybody to do it, all the panelists included. So you will find 24 cue cards. Each card will have half quote, and the other half quote will be there only. I'm not saying it will be missing. It will be there only, but you need to find where is the other half and you need to match them. How to match them? You will have to just go and click on card number one, which you think is the first half. And then you click on the card number two, which you think is the second half. And if the quote will be full, and if the quote is correct, what will happen? The color of the cards will change. And when the colors change, you be happy because you are able to do your job well. But my dear friends, do not forget one thing. Once you match all the cue cards, it's like matching the pairs activity. Once you match all the cue cards, what you need to do is you need to, on the top right hand side of the screen, there will be a message button icon of message over there. You need to click it. You need to submit your name and your email address, and your task will come to me, and I will be able to see whether you have completed your task or not. And I tell you, your certificates will also depend upon this task. So everybody must do it. Unless you complete the task, I am sorry, but we will show to you in the next session that yes, you did not complete the task. So are you all ready for the task? I will type the link for you. And I want you to say yes, yes, if you are ready for the task. And the link has been sent to all of you. So now no more messaging so that everybody can see the link. Please don't type anything in the chat box so that people can locate the link. I hope you have received this task. You have opened this task, and time to complete this task is 2 minutes. Sir, 2 minutes is fine, or should I give 3 minutes? What do you say?
Yeah, well, they are teachers. They are quite fast, so we can give them 2 minutes.
Let me ask the head office. What does head office say? Should you want to give 2 minutes or 3 minutes?
I think 2 minutes is over. It's okay because of the teaching community we are dealing with.
Great, great. So you have 2 minutes and the time has already started. I will start the timer in my phone, and I have started the timer. And I'll share with you. This is the task that you can see in your mobile phone. And I'll show you how to do it. Yes, I have done one task. You can see I have completed 2 tasks. and the time is over. I hope you all have completed the task.
Sir, I suggest if we give them more 30 seconds, sir, if you don't mind.
Okay, no problem. 30 seconds given. I need to take the permission of the head office. What do you say, sir? Dhananjay, sir. Ravi sir is asking 30 minutes more.
Yeah, we believe that the learning should be learner-centric.
Yes. Okay.
No,
okay.
Some of them have some network connections, sir, so that's the reason, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You all have completed. It is difficult to do on the phone. So many, yeah, it is. I can understand. It is rather, I would.
If you look at the protocol, we mentioned that it is always better to join on a large screen, yeah. Because it has the limitation. The cell phones have the screen size limitation, but nonetheless, we understand we are all in the pandemic situation. So handphone are very, very convenient for us, but that is the limitation it has. We have to bear with it.
Correct. And once you complete the task, you need to send the task. You need to press the message button. Once you receive the message of congratulations, you need to send the entire task to me. Once you complete the task like this, if you see the screen, there is a message button at the top right hand side of the right hand corner of your screen, the message button. You will have to click the message and it will ask you student name, student email. And once you complete this, then the task is completed. So I will write my name. My name is Noor Ali. Noor means light, Ali means the name of the God. So you can say my name means the light of the God. I love my name. You all must be loving your name. So I will type the email address and then I will send it. Your answers were sent successfully, the message that you will get. And once you get this message, then you need to just say okay, and then you can type the message in the chat box that yes, you have completed your job. So now, shall we move ahead with our session? Ravi sir, we have given enough time, I suppose, and all the teachers, if they have not completed, they should complete it, and they should be able to share it later with us. But look at those powerful statements which you matched. We were just matching it, but I would just like to spend just one moment of yours on these powerful statements, which will not only tell you what is your worth, what kind of job you need to do, what is expected out of you, what is your worth, and the kind of power that you create with this profession. You saw it by yourself when you matched. And out of this, my favorite, I would like to tell you, the one that touches my heart is right there on your screen. I'll tell you what it is. And that is my favorite, which says the best teachers are those who show you what? Who show you what? Where to look, but don't tell you what to see. You may be just a teacher, but to your students, you are a hero all these things. Teaching is like theater. Teaching is to learn twice. Teaching is the greatest act of optimism. So all these things are telling us how powerful our profession is, how noble our profession is. We are creating futures of tomorrow. We are creating the world for tomorrow. So let me go back to my presentation, and I'll come to a point which you all want to know. What are the essentials? What is something which is very, very important in teaching? This was the activity that we did. This was a link which I shared. This is what we did. But do you know these people? If you know, you can type the names. Do you know these people? Okay, you can type the names. I'll come to know whether you know them or not. They have a story for you. And I'm sure it is going to be an interesting story for all of us. Yes, only Bill Gates. Great. Okay. The another one is a great motivational speaker from America. His name is Les Brown. Another one, you popularly know him, you all know him, is Bill Gates, right? I would like to tell you one important thing about Mr. Bill Gates is that he was, when he was a student, he was nerdy, he liked reading, he was a child with a lot of enthusiasm and a lot of interest for learning, and he credits his growth as a person to one of the teachers who appeared to him as a librarian. And how did it change his life? I want to read out something for you. The name of the teacher who changed the life for Bill Gates, if you can read it in his biography, you can read it in one of his mentions also, is Mrs. Blanche Caffery. She was the elegant and engaging school librarian at Seattle's View Ridge Elementary. And Bill Gates says, I was a timid fourth grader. I was desperately trying to go unnoticed because I had some big defects like atrocious handwriting. And I was trying to hide the fact that I liked to read, something that was cool for girls, but not for boys. Mrs. Caffery took me under her wing and helped make it okay for me to be a messy, nerdy boy who was reading lots of books. But that's not enough. That's not what I want to say here. The real thing comes later. Now, he credits Mrs. Caffery for helping him escape his shell in the true spirit of exceptional teaching. First, what she did, I'm reading it out loud for you. First, she encouraged Gates. She encouraged Gates' passion for reading by helping him explore. And then with the help of introspective questions such as what he liked to read and why. The next thing she did was she went out of the way and shared some progressive, interesting, and challenging books for him. And when he would read it, she would sit down beside Gates and learn from Mr. Gates what he read in the book and why. And she genuinely listened to what Gates had to say. That's what the impact Mr. Gates had about the teacher. And when Mrs. Caffery was about 100 years on her 100th birthday, Bill Gates was able to thank that librarian, that teacher who encouraged, who helped him reflect on what he was reading and why he was reading. And he was challenged by the books which were given by Mrs. Caffery. That is the role of the teacher that was played by one interesting teacher in the life of Bill Gates. We all know Bill Gates now, but Bill Gates is largely Bill Gates, also because of small little contributions of so many people, and one out of them was a teacher. Let us take a look at the case of Les Brown. Les Brown was a struggling child in the class. He always struggled. He was labeled as mentally handicapped, educable, mentally handicapped. So one day, he was also, you know, he was transferred from sixth grade to fifth grade. So what happened one day, one teacher came to the class and asked Les to solve the problem on the board. Les refused, Brown refused and said that, no, I couldn't. Then teacher said, of course you can. Why you can't? Young man, come up here and solve this problem for me. That's what the teacher mentioned. But Les insisted. Les said that, no, I am educable, mentally handicapped, is what Les said. The rest of the class then erupted in laughter. Teacher stopped everybody. He took the child, looked in his eyes, told Les that don't ever say this again. He told him firmly, someone else's opinion of you should not become your own opinion, should not become a reality. And Les was impacted by this statement. It made a profound impact in his life. And then he became one of the most sought after, very famous American motivational speaker. You can see for yourself, this is the impact of the teaching. That's what I wanted to share with you with these two examples. And that's what I mean here on the screen. When we say that we are teachers, our heart is slightly bigger than the others, because we create all the other professions. And to teach effectively is to touch the life forever. That's what we mean by our heart being bigger than the average human heart. We have a lot of space. We have a lot of love. We have a lot of compassion, not only for our subject, but for pupil and education per se. That's what our role is going to be. And we all want to fill this bracket when we say, I-teaching. What you would like to put here? I give you two options. One is like, or another is love. What is your opinion? You can type me in the chat box and I'll be able to know what is your opinion. You can let me know by typing it in your chat box. Yes, you will have to choose this option. Love, love, love. All of you would say, yes, we love teaching. We love teaching. Because love is the cornerstone of everything, every great thing. When you have passion, when you have love, great things are supposed to happen, are bound to happen. I would not use this word, not use this word supposed, but I would say they are bound to happen. Yeah, thank you very much. And when we say we love teaching, then we must understand every teacher will have three loves, not one, two, but three. What is the first love? Love for learning. You remember, teacher is a learner. The first statement that Dhananjay sir made today in the meeting was, we as teachers need to become a lifelong learner first. We need to learn. And to teach is to learn. When you see the mirror image of teach, it says learn. So first we must have love for learning. That is the first love. The second one is love for learners. All the teachers, they become very happy when they see students in the class. It should bring smile on the face. It should not bring frown on the face. It should not become a tedious job. It should not tax you. It should not become burden. It should not be considered as a load. It should bring smile on your face. And the third love is of putting both the loves together, love of learning and love of learners. When we put these both the loves together, then we get our third love. So I want all of you to remember, what do you like teaching or do you love teaching? But when you say, yes, you love teaching, you need to remember the three loves. I will ask you at the end of the session, if the time permits, what are the three loves? One is love for learning. Second is love of learners. Third is love of bringing the first two loves together. That's what we mean by teaching. And yes, I have one more activity to go. We have about 10, 12 minutes, and we are going to talk about teaching essentials. So I want to first show you something on the screen. But before that, I want to ask you whether you are focusing and attention is there on the screen or not, whether you are watching the screen or not. If you are watching the screen, you can type yes, yes in the chat box. Are you watching the slide? If you are watching, you can type yes, yes. So I come to know that yes, you are all watching the slide. Thank you very much. I see your answer. So I'm here to present this graph to all of you, which will tell you something about what are the essentials in teaching. And that's why I call it teaching essential. On one axis, that is x-axis and y-axis, we all must have worked a lot on the graph, but there is something that we can learn from this graph, that is will and skill. These are the two most important components of the teacher or for any profession, not teaching per se, take any profession, but we are taking teaching into consideration right now. So we will look at these components in that light. Do you think will is important in teaching? Will to learn, willingness to learn, and willingness to teach? Do you think will is important? If you think it is important, you can type yes in the chat box. Will. Agar will may say, if you just remove W from the will, what remains? What remains? If you just take away W from the word will, what remains? It will remain ILL. Means it will show that ill, we are not well, if we don't have the W, that will, that work, if we don't have, then we will appear like ill. And on the y-axis, we have seen the word skill, which is again another important thing. Skill, how to teach. What to teach, we all know, but how to teach is also important. And that requires a lot of upskilling, a lot of learning, continuous learning. When you learn, you improve your skill. And that's where it becomes an important component. And if you remove S from the skill, then it will turn it as skill. And S stands for study over there. S stands for study. If you don't study, then it is going to either kill you or kill the subject or kill the object or kill the person who is the benefit or the recipient of it. So if we don't continuously study, our skill will not remain skill anymore. So it means will and skill are the most important thing. But let us take a look at one more thing here. How we use this, which defines our state as a teacher. Let's say if we are here, if the will is less, if the skill is less, what will happen? It will be a poor result. Absolutely poor results we will get from our profession. Let's take a look at the second significant state. If we acquire a lot of skill, we know everything. We are able to do a good job, whether it is online, offline. If we are very effective with our skill, but if we don't have will, we have good skill, but no will, what will happen is we will become ineffective. We will not sound appealing. We will not sound interesting. Will has to be there, which is missing. But here we see the will is high, but the skill is low. The desire to learn, teach is high, but ability to grasp, ability to do it accurately is less. And that's why the results will be mediocre. And when you have both the things in equal proportion, when you have both the things, will and skill, you become very, very effective. I learned in one of the workshops, online workshop, and I would like to share it with you over here. Another major component in teaching is the ability to speak and ability to listen. Tell me, what is more important in teaching and learning? Speaking is more important or listening is more important according to you? I want your opinion. What do you think? What is more important, speaking or listening? You can type it in the chat box. I'll come to know what you are voting for, whether speaking or whether listening. What do you think? Both of them. Listening. Okay. So many answers. Very happy. Listening. Great. Let us compare the results like in the previous slide, which we would like to show it to you here on the screen. What happens if you are not having the ability to speak well in the class? And what we learn by communication, we go back to our previous class where Dhananjay sir explained us about the theory of Mehrabian, how important communication is in teaching. And the communication has two important components. One is speaking, another is listening. If the speaking is not good, and if the listening is not good, what will be the result? Your pupils, your students will not like you. They will not come closer to you. They will not like your subject. That's what it is. You need to go back and see, how am I at speaking and how am I at listening? Both the things we need to see. If we are able to speak well, then are we able to listen well also? That's very important. But in this case, we are talking about both the things being less. Let us take a look at one more situation. If I am only speaking well, and if I can't listen, and listening does not necessarily mean only words. Listening, the expressions also in the class. You can see so many expressions in the class. Some people speak, some don't, but still you are supposed to listen everything, everybody. That's where it is important. If I can only speak, but I'm not ready to listen, then my students may get bored. But if I only listen, but I don't speak well, I'm good at listening, I'm able to listen, I'm able to judge the expression, but I'm not able to convey that well, maybe I will be liked by my students. But when you want your students to love you, you need to have both in equal proportions. That's what I would like to say. Thank you very much. I was really, really very happy to meet you here and to share with you what my little knowledge has served me over the years, spending my life in teaching and learning and training teachers being an academician. I would like to say whatever learnings I have generated for myself, I have tried to impart it to you. Now the house is open. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. And in all my might, I will try and answer it. But I would like to tell you, I am not the repository of all the wisdom that is available on earth. If I may not answer you, my colleagues may answer. If my colleagues are not able to answer, we will come back to you with the answer and we will surely clear your doubt. That's what I would like to say. The time is running out and we have to move at 2:30. I'm giving you very less time to ask questions, but you can post questions. Probably, if not, we are not able to take the questions now. We will take the questions in the upcoming sessions, which is scheduled day after tomorrow. So now the house is open. Thank you very much for your patience, for your positivity, and for your participation. You have given me 3 P's, not 2. I am more than happy with all of you. Remember the things that we have learned today, because the next thing in the next session I'm going to ask you is a summary from all of you. And if you are able to remember and retain it, then I'm sure we will make a lot of difference in our profession. Thank you very much. Over to you, sir. If there are any questions, we would like to take the questions here now.
Yeah, there is one question which I like to highlight here. It says that the example of what you have delivered to the real teaching and learning English for our non-English speaker students. So one thing I just would like to point out here, the subject is not very much specific to English learning here in this workshop. We are not actually focusing on the English per se as a teaching or as a learning. But since you have pointed out this question, I got just immediate, very quick response to you. I will share with you what we had applied somewhere for non-English speaking students. You know, yesterday we discussed about first we need to make them learn the component skill. If you want to learn a skill, first you have to break it in the components and make them learn those components. Then in practice them integrating those components and let them know how to integrate all these. So Nurali, if you stop your presentation, I have just quick one slide to show you. Maybe later I can send it to you. The name of the gentleman is, I'll just see, Uzli Fatul. Yeah. So I'll share this document with you because we don't have time. So just to show you the applied way of teaching the component skill for English language. And the entire English language we have divided into 48 sentences. That's it. So when we tell to the students, you just need to learn these 48 sentences over. And we make it like a poem. Bird does sing, bird did sing, bird will sing. Bird does not sing, bird did not sing, bird will not sing. Like that. So there are 48 questions. We make them learn like a poem. Once they learn it, then we come to tell them that what it is actually and how to integrate it in a sentence. And then the rule and all those tense chart come later. But first, this poem is important for them. They mug it up 48 sentences and then they integrate it and they use it in their language. I will share this document with you. If you find it, it is helpful to you. Over to Ravi ji. We are done with our end.
Sir, thank you so much. On behalf of the teachers, please allow me to thank once again for the wonderful session. Thank you so much, Dhananjay sir. Thank you so much, Mr. Nurali. Getting comments, you are the best, and I can tell you, today you will also, along with Dhananjay sir, you will also going to be popular in Indonesia, in the province called Jawa Timur. They've all enjoyed the session. There's someone asking, can we have the copy of the PowerPoint? I think. As mentioned by Dhananjay sir, that probably not the copy of the PowerPoint, but the video link will be shared. Please correct my understanding, Dhananjay sir.
That's right. Yeah, it is already there on YouTube.
And Ravi sir, for today's session, if they can give some testimonials, if they can give some feedback, we'll be more than happy. And that is the breakfast of the champions, as we say. Feedback will keep us motivated for the upcoming session.
For sure, sir. That definitely, sir. We will be taking the testimonials also. Yeah. Right. So once again, sir, Dhananjay, sir, and also Noor, sir, thank you so much, sir. Wonderful presentation, wonderful session. Everyone is enjoying. Again, today we have hit a record 400 plus. Till the end. I mean, I can tell you that's a record. So thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Okay, Bapak Ibu. So Bapak Ibu, kita udah kirimin yang link nih, Bapak Ibu, untuk yang feedbacknya dan kehadiran. Tolong Bapak Ibu diisi. Tolong diisi nih, Bapak Ibu. Please do that. Regarding the material, I repeat, the copy of the PowerPoint we will not be available. We apologize for it, but please remember, a PowerPoint does not speak, but the video is much more helpful. And Marwari University will be sharing the link of the video link. So I'm sure y'all will be much more happier, much more, I think it will, it's much more better to have a video link rather than a PowerPoint, Bapak Ibu, right? So the video link will be shared with y'all like the day one. So thank you so much. Thanks a lot once again for your active participation. I've already shared the link for the feedback form and kehadiran. Bapak Ibu, please make sure, please fill it up. Just 2 minutes, sir. Well, just to finish this process, sir. Bapak Ibu, the chat box uda kirim link tentang feedback sama kehadiran. Bapak Ibu, tolong diisikan. Silakan diisi, Bapak Ibu. Terima kasih. Thank you. Dhananjay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, would it be possible, I mean, just a question, sorry, I should have spoken to you about this earlier. Can we allow them to open their cameras, because some of them would like to take a photograph with you on the screen with also Mr. Noor Ali. Is it possible, sir, to open the video camera to all, so that let them be there, let them take photos, and I can tell you they love to share. So if you don't mind.
Sure.
Okay, Papa Ibu, the cameras will be open for all. I request you all to please open the cameras. I mean, open your microphones, not your microphone. You all can open your microphones also for sure. But also please open your cameras and please take photographs, Papa Ibu, and please share the photographs. These are great moments. These are moments which need to be captured. So let's capture it, Papa Ibu. So please open your cameras.
Just 10 seconds. It is taking little
time. Yeah, 10 seconds, Papa Ibu. Just wait for 10 seconds. The cameras will be open. Thank you.
I would like to say so many good things for your feedback. You have been very kind and generous for sharing these kind words with me. Really very happy, thankful to all of you. Thank you very much.
Bapa Ibu, if you all want to make a report, please make a report with the link, with the video link. I understand from the ministry, maybe you'll have to make a report. Please make a report from the link, because in the link, everything would be there. I mean, the whole session is recorded, so you all can definitely do it, please. Sir, could we also unmute their microphone, sir? I think some of them would like to speak something, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, I have to do one by one. I think.
Oh, okay. Unmute all, sir. I mean.
No.
Okay, Papa Ibu, please open your microphones. No, I mean, please open your cameras, and you all can take photographs, Papa Ibu. I know in Indonesia, without photograph, it doesn't end. So please do take photographs. Please do take photographs with everyone. There you go. Ibu Tanti is here.
Wait a minute. It is to allow the cameras, because it is in a webinar mode, the camera is not allowing to switch on. Maybe we can take tomorrow if the settings permit.
Oh, okay.